would like to take a quick minute in return on what we did yesterday. It's just 6 7 tonight, so I'll think to do very quickly. At the opening ceremony, Mr. Chairman, we had presentations by the Speaker of the State House of Assembly and good messages from many partners, including some of our traditional leaders like the Sultan of Sokoto and the Emir of Kaduna. In summary, Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, yesterday the State House of Assembly committed to continue to collaborate with the executive and promote business and economic activity in the state. The legislature also committed to networks that will aid that again the needs of doing business in Kaduna. They have already done a lot. Our state of assembly, Mr. Chairman, is probably the most prolific legislature in Nigeria. We have passed more than 23 bills in less than 24 months. We also announced yesterday that our international revenue increased from about 13 billion in 2015 to 18 billion in 2016 without raising any taxes by just improving collections. We launched our state development plan 2016 to 2020 last year. And this year we are going to detail out that plan by launching sector implementation plan. We also announced that we are deploying technology to boost human capital development, but also to use selected technologies to fight crime, like drones, cross-site television, and so on. This we are deploying primarily in Kaduna, and then for other cities and towns in the state. As part of our human capital development, Mr. Chairman, this year, in this year's budget, we aim to spend about 20 billion naira to start a school shooting program. We have over 4,000 primary schools that are in various states of disrepair or congestion. With the support of the World Bank, we hope to start the construction of multi-story schools in Kaduna so that more of our children will be accommodated within the same land that we have. We awarded contracts to convert the local hospital along the Abuja Kaduna Road into a world-class trauma center so that we can save lives on that road. Mr. Chairman, we call the House our former Deputy National Development Advisor and the Minister of our Labour on that road. We hope that Doka will come to for saving lives there. Our media will be developed here in Kaduna in partnership with private sector organizations. In my opinion, Mr. Chairman, sir, the highlight of yesterday's opening ceremony were the interventions by the Sultan of Sokoto as well as Royal Highness the Emir of Kaduna. Mr. Chairman, sir, for the first time in Nigeria's history, our traditional rulers are speaking out on social policies and drawing the attention of political leaders on what they need to do to make our state and our regions better. And here I would like to quote two things that in yesterday's declaration. He said a nation and state only transformed by vision. If the vision is flawed, then everything is automatically flawed. You also had a warning against borrowing, that growth only comes from investment and not from borrowing. At the end of the day, Mr. Chairman, we made some announcements. I would like to welcome His Excellency the Governor of Kano State, Dr. El-Rufai. Please help me. The first being presentation of a sector implementation plan, which I tried for the state development plan. Yesterday, we also presented the Kaduna State Infrastructure Master Plan for 2018-2015. We tried to look ahead, like 2 years ahead, and develop an infrastructure plan for the state. It's a draft of discussion, and we presented it yesterday to get feedback from the citizens of the state as well as all other sector experts. We also signed development cooperation agreements with the United Kingdom Department for International Development, the U.S. Agency for International Development, and UNICEF. We also announced our citizen feedback web-based platform called IITS. Later today, the Commissioner of Budget and Guidance will make a later presentation of this. But essentially, what you see, Mr. Chairman, is on a smartphone platform. You can download an app and be able to monitor projects all across the state. You can take pictures and send pictures. You can send reports and opinions on our projects and on our staff, which I received in key ministries, department and agencies, as well as the governor's office. It will be presented later and explained by the Commissioner of Budget and Planning to get ahead of the development of this app. I will offer this app to all the governors. And indeed, two governors have already sent delegations to take this app and use it for project monitoring. Because in the office of government, you can see what is happening on all the projects. As long as someone with a smartphone wants to ask them, it will be presented later. Yesterday, the State Chairman was also unveiled our East of Green Business Charter. Kaduna State is committed to making this state the easiest place to do business in Nigeria. Made some significant progress already. Business is run out of the easiest place to do business in Nigeria in 2017. But we want to do more. And yesterday we announced commitments. How long it will take for you to get the occupancy in Kaduna once you pay all the site credits? And how long it will take you to get line up once you submit the drawings and pay all the fees? So we made this commitment. And we got all the commissioners to sign this, and we hope that next year we report back on progress. Finally, we also presented our 2017 citizens' budget in a format that citizens can understand. We also had some plenary sessions at TSA. The first plenary session was the summary of investors' experience in Kaduna. We got companies that are already doing business in Kaduna to give their own stories, their own experiences of dealing with the state government, dealing with our officials. And most of what we had was possible. And indeed, some of the investors have announced plans to make new investments. And Flower Leaves yesterday announced that they established a fertilizer building and a feed building plant in Kaduna State the next 1 year. Green Energy, the French electricity company, confirmed its readiness to launch all green power sources that will supply electricity to rural communities in Kaduna. And Kaduna is committed to creating between 4 and 5,000 units every year in information communication technologies. The second plenary had to do with international partners, where our international development partners gave their own experiences and their own commitments. And here I would like to say, Mr. Chairman, we're very grateful to all our bilateral donor partners for the interest they have shown in Kaduna and the support they have given us. The UK Department for International Development has equipped like 4 of our primary health centers with solar power and innovative. We're very grateful for that. We've done the commission one of them yesterday. USAID has just signed an agreement to work with us in areas of agriculture, food security, as well as health. We've been working on the EU to improve the ease of doing business in the United States. UNICEF has been working with us on the area of nutrition, as well as many interventions providing not only financial resources but technical assistance to make our state stronger. We are very grateful to all of them for their support. At the end of, after launch yesterday, we closed and we went on to commission some of the projects that started in the last 12 months since the last election. The $150 million Kaduna poultry farm built in, which is the largest Sub-Saharan Africa, was visited yesterday. Mr. Chairman, I would like to invite you on the 12th of September to the full commissioning of this plant that will employ 300,000 farmers just for 9 days as well as this alone. This plant will ensure that, like many other states, you don't have to go to Nevada and contact to buy chicken and eggs. It's a very, very important project and it is going to be commissioned inshallah on the 12th of September. And we'd like to share with the government there. We also commissioned some houses being done by the private sector in Millennium City. And a garment factory producing uniforms for our paramilitary and military forces here in Kaduna. We commissioned the Badra Ground Center, which, as I explained, was approved by the government. We also commissioned the Kaduna ICT Hub and outsourcing facility. This was the building donated to us by the Credit Bank. And yesterday I expressed my gratitude to that local social responsibility, and we are asking other banks to consider that intervention in our state and other states. Finally, Mr. Chairman, Weber Bank, which is true from Kaduna State for many, many years, is back. And yesterday we commissioned their kind and share. In brief, this is what happened yesterday. We welcome the chairman of the governing party of Nigeria, former governor of the state, Chief John Oyeke Oyeke, my brother, other brother, the governor of Kano State, and the deputy governor of Kano State, and all of the team of Kano Investment. Thank you.